Our boy RJ Young, we're big fans of him, and he just recently moved Michigan into his number one spot. And let's listen to, you know, exactly how he felt about that as well. So RJ Young.
I moved Michigan to number one. I believe Michigan has the best win of anybody in college football. They are undefeated. We went, 9 weeks saying they ain't played nobody. They ain't played nobody. Well, they played somebody. Even if you don't think Penn State is anybody, they played Ohio State, and they beat Ohio State handily. A defense that hadn't given up more than 17 points to a single opponent gave up 30 to Michigan.
Mm. I mean, he does make a good point. He does make a good point. Sora, how you feel about what RJ Young had to say about why he put more Michigan in his number one spot?
I agree. I feel like Michigan probably will move up to number one. You just beat the number two team this previous week. They were the number one team. They had top 10 strength of schedule. I mean, that's your biggest win. That's probably the biggest win out of everybody so far in the playoffs. You could argue Georgia with Missouri because Missouri is ranked, 11?
Yeah.
About around the time.
Yeah, it was like 13.
Top 15, but still, this was number two. You did it without your head coach. Not that that deserves extra brownie points, but that's still a statement. And again, they were the number one originally. They did have a top 10 strength schedule. And then when they beat them, they were the number two team. So either way, they were still ahead of them. I agree. I would move Michigan to number one right now.
I would have to definitely agree with him on his take here. I think it is the best win so far because you got to think about what Ohio State did this year. They were the only team for the longest time that had two top 10 wins on their schedule, regardless of how both of those teams turned out. But they still had it. Playing Notre Dame at night is, I've said it before, is not an easy task. Then you go into this game in a rivalry game, and Michigan shows up and shows out. I mean, they were, outside of what the score says, they're pretty dominant on defense, and they're dominant on, especially with their running game. And again, like you said, without their coach, that's got to give you some kudos points right there.
I mean, Michigan's won how many games without their head coach? 5 or 6?
Oh, yeah, because he did get suspended at the beginning of the season,
well,
too.
Yeah, that's true. For what, 3 or 4 the first, yeah, and then so another 3?
I mean, it was against garbage teams, but yeah, I mean, it's still impressive. I mean,
but still.
You got to add, it's a resume builder. I agree. It's a resume builder at this point.
Stop it.
Jim Harbaugh, what do you think, Fishing?
So I'm going to totally agree. I want to say something about what Vic said in the chat. If you're gonna, I agree. You put Michigan at one. They got the best one in the country, and I want to ask y'all a question after this too. But Vic says if you haven't lost in 3 years, you can stay at one, and I totally get that. But the playoff committee and no ranking, there's no any type of ranking that should be looking at the past 3 years. It's only this year. It's only this year. What you've done this year, how you look this year, the players you have this year. I mean, you don't count Jordan Davis being on this team this year. Like, it's not how it works. But
Jordan Davis, Jalen Carter, Keita Ringo.
I mean, I agree that bias is in the back of people's minds. So I do understand that, but you got to look at this year. But anyway, yeah, I agree. But so the question to y'all is, do you think that, because let's be real, Washington probably has the best resume, even though they've looked really questionable in a lot of games. They probably have the best resume. They have like 4 top 20 wins. So Is 4 top 20 wins better than a top 2 win to y'all?
No.
I don't think so either. But
I think it depends on where you play. It helps out Michigan that they play crappy teams and won against the second best team at the end of the season.
Now,
versus 4
top 20 wins plus an Oregon win, which is a top 5 win. You know, it kind of gets interesting. I don't know. So, but that's, you know.
Because a lot of things can change. I mean, a facelift, right? Would you say Oregon is the same team that they were when they played Washington the first time? Exactly. So I don't know if they, it's like the Texas, do you put Texas or Alabama? Well, now you could justify it again with Texas because they look like crap against Auburn. You know what I'm saying? Like, they look very good the last like 4 weeks, and then bam, they put up a stinker against Auburn. But I don't know what the committee considered. Do you just consider wins and losses and not how you won or lost? Because I would definitely do that. Like, I'm trying to get the best matchup at the end of the day. So if I'm considering that Michigan just beat the number two school in the country versus Washington, who played all these other teams in the past, I might consider that Michigan has been smashing teams by 30 points and now they just beat the number two school, that they might be better. Yeah. I don't know that.
I love what the committee's doing this year, to be honest with you. Like, they're keeping head-to-heads in mind, but they're looking at how teams look. Like, Florida State didn't hop out of the top four.
But they controlled their own distance. Just
because Washington had the better wins. Like, they looked at the quarterback. Like, they looked at everything. But I just like how they're doing it this year because they're looking at actual play on the field. Usually, it's playoff committees, a bunch of people that just look at win-loss column and box score, and then they just vote how they vote. So they're doing it differently, which is interesting to me. So.
Vic anyway, says, so does Harbaugh make a difference? He hasn't coached most of the season, and we're talking about them at number one. Yeah, he makes a difference because when he's coaching, J.J. McCarthy looks better.
Yep, mm-hmm. Way better. Sharon Moore's an O-line coach, so you know all he wants to do is run the ball, and he's shown us all he's been doing.
Yep. O-line? I need that. We need that. Yep.
Sharon Moore's an O-line coach, so.
Source said, yeah. I needs that.
I needs that.